Welcome to the January Arias at Avos. We are thrilled to be here. Thank you to the Opera Fort Collins Guild for your support and for Fort Fund as well. I am welcoming two performers and in a different change of structure. I have them and we're going to do a quick Zoom interview so you can get to know them before you hear their beautiful voices. So I'd like to tell you just a bit about them, but before I read their bios to you, I want to let you know that these are two performers that have worked together for many years. They've performed in Italy, Japan, and Texas, and even in Alaska together. So they were gracious enough to do a distanced duet, which we are excited to share with you. Our first performer is Emily Anderson. She is a mezzo-soprano from New Mexico. She holds a Bachelor of Music in Music Education and a Performer Certificate from Sam Houston State University. And she is currently a graduate student working on her MM in Vocal Performance at Colorado State University. She has performed, as I mentioned, many, many places. Some of her favorite roles include Orpheus in Gluck's Orfeo ed Euridice, Suzuki in Puccini's Madame Butterfly, where she performed at Opera Festival di Roma, and The Sorceress in Purcell's Dido and Aeneas, where she performed both in Texas and in Japan. And fun fact, our baritone who's joining us also performed in that piece as well. You will be seeing Emily again very soon because she is singing the role of Miss Todd in Colorado State University's virtual production of Menotti's Old Maid and the Thief. And so I believe you will see her in 2 months or so. Baritone Eric Morgan grew up in Katy, Texas. His professional debut happened in 2008 when he performed in HGO's production of Britain's A Midsummer Night's Dream. He was a member of the children's chorus and he covered the role of Mustard Seed. He was also a member of the high school voice studio through HGO, where he performed lots of places and got to do a lot of great work. He went on and worked on his Bachelor's of Music from Sam Houston State University, and then he received his master's degree in voice performance at Louisiana State University. In addition to all of the places I've mentioned that he sung, he also has performed in Luxembourg, so quite the international crowd this month. And then fun fact, in his 2 years at LSU, he was able to sing 10 roles in that period of 2 years. So we are really excited to have these two performers with us today. And I wanted to have them talk to you directly. So I have some questions that I've given them and they've mulled over. The first question is, what is your favorite role or musical experience? And Eric, you can start us off.
So for favorite, I'm just trying to think about it as we've been going through this. Out of all those 10 roles, one of my favorite ones that I did at LSU was John Cree in Elizabeth Cree, because it's a very dark opera, and not to give any spoilers, but the murderer that is portrayed through the show is not the actual murderer. But as John Cree, his first three arias, you have to convince the audience that you are the murderer. And so it's not very explicit, but pretty explicit arias and content, only to be flipped at the end to see that all of the words that he was singing were written by someone else who was the actual murderer. So it was a very cool role to have to, for these arias, portray this bloodthirsty murderer, and then when on stage in the second half of the show, be this loving husband that's not aware of any of this that is happening. And so it was a really cool dichotomy to have to work with.
That is really fun and interesting. Wonderful. How about you, Emily? What are your favorite roles or musical experiences?
Well, I did a lot of musical theater and opera through high school and college. And so I kind of have like a tie, one for opera and one for musical theater. For opera, I think by far, my favorite role so far has been the sorcerer in Sam Houston State University's production of Dido and Aeneas. We did this absolutely awesome production where we basically had a cast of singers and a cast of dancers portraying each role. And so what was really unique was I had dance experience. You know, I even got a minor in dance as part of my bachelor's. And so I, you know, while I was doing all of my big, powerful, evil singing, which is always just fun for a mezzo anyway, I was also getting to do some dancing. And so it was really nice to actually get to use some of my other skills. For musical theater, my favorite role has been Fiona in Shrek the Musical. I find her just to be absolutely relatable. And also I get to tap dance with mice on the stage. Like, it's great. It's perfect. And it was just such a fun experience for me.
That sounds like an experience that you can tell your children and grandchildren about, and they will love it. Okay. How about, Emily, we're going to stick with you. What would a dream role be for you?
Again, I've got one for each. I always do. I'll start with musical theater this time. My dream role since I was like six, is the witch from Stephen Sondheim's Into the Woods. And funny story, my mother was in a production of Into the Woods. She played the wicked stepmother. And she loves to tell the story about how when I was about six, and she was in this production, the witch couldn't show up for one of her rehearsals one day, like she was sick or something came up. And, you know, the poor director was like, oh, I guess I'm going to have to stand in for the witch. But because I was raised by a single mom, I was going to every rehearsal. And so I, as a precocious six-year-old child, stepped in and just did the entire rehearsal as the witch. And everyone thought it was the greatest thing ever. So it's been my dream ever since to try and reprise that experience. And then for opera, I think the role that I would most love to play is Isabella in Rossini's L'Italiana in Algeri. She's very strong and in her convictions, and she's very aware of who she is as a person. And, you know, I love Rossini in general just because I think that he does comic opera so well. But especially with Isabella, you know, she's always pulling all of the strings to try and make it work so that everybody ends up safe and alive in a situation that I'm sure she never imagined herself being in. And so I find that very admirable.
I think I lost sound.
Sorry
about that. So for my dream role, I don't want to downplay the opera, but it's such a common role, but I really want to perform professionally the Count in Marriage of Figaro. It's just, I love playing an angry person on stage because I like to think I'm not like that in person, but also I love that role because he's just so dumb. And everyone around him knows exactly what is happening and they're all playing against him. And so every time he's on stage, he's just 10 steps behind everyone else. And so I love that experience. And I would really love to perform it. I've performed the aria so many times. I've done scenes, but have never been able to perform the full role.
That's probably one of my dream roles too, Eric. Okay, so then you both actually have a Colorado connection. So tell us how you came to know Colorado. Go ahead, Eric.
So when was it? I think it was 2017. We were the inaugural class of Musica Montaigne in Boulder, Colorado, where it was an early music festival with the Boulder Bach Society, correct? Yeah, and we traveled with our early music ensemble from San Vicente State with about three or four instrumentalists and three vocalists, and we performed the Coffee Cantata. And so it was just a wonderful experience to dive into those roles and get a week and a half deep dive into early music and its practice and its performance.
Yeah, it was an absolutely wonderful experience. You know, we went with Professor Mario Oshauer, who actually knew Zachary Carrotin, who was, you know, the one who was spearheading all of this, because Zachary Carrotin himself came from Sam Houston and was the orchestra director like 2 or 3 years previous. And so it was really wonderful getting that full collaborative experience. And it was one that we kind of didn't really get to get for very long at Sam Houston. You know, we were fortunate enough to get it as part of Dido and Aeneas because we were collaborating with the early music ensemble then. But for the most part, it was a very unique experience getting to perform with like period style instruments and in a very distinct style, but also to be able to draw on our experience as people studying opera. It was really wonderful.
That's great. Wow. And then also, because singing has become less ubiquitous since the pandemic began, some people have started doing some different things in their quarantine lifestyles. So I just wanted to ask you each, what have you been up to? Emily, I know you've been very busy being a student, but what have you been up to?
Yeah, I've been, you know, I'm now in my second semester of my master's at Colorado State, and I'm also a graduate assistant. So a lot of my time has been dedicated to running a Voice One class. On top of that, I've also been working on building an aria package for competitions. I am still a very young singer. I turned 24 literally yesterday. And so I'm just starting to try and build up a package that can show off my versatility, I suppose, while I'm auditioning for companies and young artist programs within the next couple of years.
Eric?
So very outside of the musical world, I have found a full-time job as a video game tester, and I've been an avid video game player since 2000 when I got my first console. I still have that console in the closet, but I was able to find in Baton Rouge at LSU in the computer science department is a branch of EA, Electronic Arts. And so I am just working from 4 p.m. to 1 a.m. every day of the week. It's completely shifted my schedule to where sometimes I'm scared of missing something that is at 1 o'clock in the afternoon because I might sleep through it. I've completely shifted up my whole sleep and living schedule. But on top of that, in the quarantine, I have still been able to work with the local opera company, Opera Louisiane, and I am a part of their singing telegrams. So we do some quarantined, go to their driveway, sit in front of their house and sing. I was able to take for a nurse's birthday, sing to her right outside the hospital. So I've been able to get some of my musical fix in with that, as well as just have my own personal time to work on roles that I haven't yet done.
That sounds amazing and lovely. Yeah. That makes me so happy. Well, before I let you all go, I just wanted to see if you would tell us about the pieces you're singing today. Just tell us about you know, who composed them, what it's about, so that they know what they're watching as they enjoy your singing. So, Eric, why don't you go first? Give us a little rundown.
So I don't know what order they will be in, but I will be singing Heggie's 100,000 Stars, which is from his 2016 and then revised in 2018 opera To Remain. And it's a two-parter where each act is a different story of a survivor of the Holocaust. And in the act that I will be performing from, I am the ghost of someone who died in Auschwitz, and I am coming back to visit my lover as a ghost, like I said. And he is an older man. And so I am now visiting him, and we are consoling each other, telling each other everything that we couldn't, making sure that each other are okay. And in this piece, I am singing of the thousands of stars that have been taken from the sky as we hear the trains passing by, and not to worry because no matter what, 100 million stars will be born to fill that sky again. And so it's a story of sadness, but hope for the future that better times will come. And then I will also be singing the Count's aria. So you get that bumbling idiot that has just heard that someone who he thinks he's got the upper hand of has said something very different. And so he is angry and he's trying to figure out what they're planning and try to get the upper hand again. And not really, you know, he's failing at it, I guess. But, and then I will be singing Finishing the Hat from Sondheim's Sunday in the Park with George. And this is the inner machinations of the artist's mind trying to deal with life, love, art that's just not coming together, and he just cannot finish that hat. He's worried about his lover leaving, the rest of the painting that he can't get done, but the hat is just stuck in his brain, and he's trying to finish it and get it all together. And my last piece, I'm trying to remember what I... The last piece will be Dandini's aria from La Cenerentola from Rossini. And so this is the Italian opera of Cinderella, but there's not really any magic in this one. And so in this aria, the prince has switched places with his servant, his helper, and I am the helper, and I am in the role of the prince. And so the prince is on the side watching as everyone is interacting with me, and I am from a lowly upbringing, finally at the point of greatness. So I get to do whatever I want and treat everyone however I want. And so it's fun ensues and a lot of laughters.
Great. Thank you. Emily, how about you?
First off, I love that you're doing Dandini. that was something that Eric and I did. Well, he was in a production of Cenerentola in Italy when I was doing Madame Butterfly, and it is by far one of my favorite of your roles. But I will also be, I stuck mostly to a little bit more art song focused. I am doing In the Beginning from Jake Heggie's Of Gods and Cats. Which is basically putting God in the form of a cat. And it's everything you would expect with that. It is, I have no other explanation beyond that. I am also doing Il pleure dans mon coeur by Claude Debussy. And that is discussing how I am just horribly sad and how my sadness is being reflected in nature around me, but I realize that I really don't have any reason to be just sad, and I'm very confused by that, and then I eventually decide maybe that's okay. So I, you know, always kind of picture it as trying to accept the fact that you are depressed and just trying to figure out how to move on from it a little bit. I am also going to be singing, well, what did I send you? Oh, I will also be singing Faites-lui, mes aveux from Charles Gounod's Faust. I am portraying Sia Belle, who is in love with Marguerite, who is the heroine. And in this aria, I am trying to figure out how to tell her without actually telling her, because that's scary. And so I decide to give her a flower that will reflect my love for her. And I just basically am battling over that. And then my last piece, well, again, we don't know what order, but I will also be singing Miller's Son from A Little Night Music. And that is basically, I will be discussing how I'm imagining the future and the different paths that I could take in my life, depending on who I marry. And, you know, discussing how that's kind of in the future. And that's okay, because in the meanwhile, I have other things I'm gonna do.
Great, wonderful. And then they also put together a digital duet, which is La Ti Darem La Mano, which is from Don Giovanni. And I don't know that I need to say very much about that. I believe Eric is trying to seduce Emily, and I haven't seen it yet, so I don't know how successful he is in this rendition. But anyways, thank you so much for tuning in. We're so excited to share these singers with you. And again, thank you to the Opera for Collins Guild and to Fort Fun for your support. And if you feel so inclined, we encourage you to make a donation, and the link is going to be at the end of the video and then also in the description right below. So thank you so much. Have a beautiful beginning to 2021.
Vinta la causa, causa sempre, in qual agio io cantea. Perfidi, io voglio di tal modo punirmi. A piacer mio la sentenza sarà.
Desire, e posseder dovrò.
Tra le belle magero e di nero ne ho vedute già tante e poi tante ma non trovo il giudizio un squisito per me, un boccone squisito per me, un boccone squisito per me. Un boccone squisito per me. Thank you.
without peur. The ether stirred, and there was milk, and the cat saw that it was good. It was good. And the cat went forth into the bag and seen that it was good. She fell asleep.
Yeah.
passing by. Another star has vanished, stolen from the skies. Hush, my love.
And the bosoms that droop and go dry in the
a rip in the bustle and a rustle in the hay, and I'll flip quick, fantastic, with flings of confetti in my petticoats away up high. It's a very short road from the fling, that's for fun, to the thigh, pressing under the table. It's not much of a stretch till you're stuck with just one, or it has to be done on the sly. Now meanwhile, there are mouths to be kissed before mouths to be fed, and there's many a tryst and there's many a bed.
She left me, as I always knew she would. I had thought she understood. They have never understood, and no reason that they should. But if anybody could, finishing the hat, I have to finish the hat. Watch the rest of the world from a window while you finish the hat. Mapping out a sky. What you feel when planning a sky. What you feel when voices that come through the window go until they distance and die. Until there's nothing but sky. And I always
Thank you.
La terra ristorante.